king of the swingers, oh, the jungle VIP. I've reached the top and had to stop, and that's what's bothering me. I want to be a man cub, and stroll right into town, and be just like the other men. I'm tired of mugging around. Oh, ooby-doo, I want to be like you. I want to walk like you, talk like you. You see, it's true. An ape like me can't learn to be human too.
New one.
Yes.
Yeah. Look, I believe it was closer to the book that it's based on than the 1967 Disney film. And I love how it's a lot darker.
In some ways, yeah.
And longer as well. It's a substantially longer film. I think it goes for about an hour and 40 minutes
An hour and 45 minutes,
yeah. And, you know, I was sitting there in the cinema. I didn't go to the media screening. I went just on a normal day, and I was sitting behind a mother with her three children, and they were absolutely terrified, you know, of Shere Khan and the wolves, and particularly Christopher Walken's orangutan.
The orangutan.
Yeah. And I was just thinking, this is the way Jungle Book was supposed to be, because it's a little boy lost in the jungle. A jungle where he grew up, the only one of his kind in the jungle, who was raised by wolves but then turned on by his wolf family in order to protect themselves, and let loose alone in the jungle all by himself, of course with his friend Bagheera and later Baloo.
And Baloo,
But there's something quite scary for children to watch on the screen.
Especially
to be put in that situation where, what would happen if I didn't have parents? What would happen if I didn't have a family and I was left alone in this world, in this relentless world, to look after myself? I thought that's the angle the new film explored better than the Disney cartoon. Because the Disney cartoon was happy, it was colorful, it made you feel so good.
Yeah.
And it's an amazing film.
Yeah.
And I believe it's a far more superior film. But just in the angle that I pointed out, the new Jon Favreau-directed film was very, very good.
It was good in many ways. I can agree with you there. But at the same time, there were things there that I didn't like.
Yeah.
I mean, the fact is
that... The CGI wasn't... It still has... It's still not as polished
exactly,
as it could be.
Exactly.
Yeah.
And I mean, for me, The Jungle Book, 1967... Classic original was my favorite Disney film.
Oh, absolutely.
I had it on VHS, I watched it non-stop.
Yeah.
Could recall bare necessities so many times to the point where my parents would just say, shut up. And it was just an amazing movie.
And of course they reused the bare necessities in the new one.
Which is fantastic. I
do you think that's fantastic?
Yes.
You like that?
I do. Okay. Because the original, that's what made it what was so good. Bare necessities and Trust in Me with Carl's song, which was a shame how they only showed it at the
King
credits.
King Louis. Yeah. But don't you think in the new film, and that's one thing I didn't really like about it, is they knew that the bare necessities was a success from the first film, so they overused it. They sang it like four or five times in the new movie, and I'm like, okay, that's taking it a little too far with the, you know.
To be fair though, they kind of did it a few times in the 1967 version as well.
They did, but it comes from the 1967 version.
I guess
so. It's their song.
They can do it as many times as they want.
Look, I mean, the new film is also a Disney production.
Yes.
And so was the 1994 live action movie with Brendan Lee.
But it wasn't good.
It wasn't good. The animals weren't talking.
No.
He was by himself, kind of, and he was in more contact with humans in that film.
And it was vicious.
Yeah.
It was, I mean, I remember seeing it when it came back on TV as a TV movie.
Yeah.
And my parents were like, oh, you know, you want to watch The Jungle Book?
He's not an Indian, so he didn't really fit that Jungle Book role to a T.
I guess they couldn't find anyone else.
Oh, man, there are heaps of Indian actors. Particularly now in Hollywood, they've really...
Nowadays. But back in the
90s,
it was pretty scarce. I mean, what, they had to actually get a white man to play Gandhi. Exactly.
Well, no. Ben Kingsley is half Indian.
Half.
Yeah,
but he's
and he looks Indian as
which
well.
Which is funny because he's in this movie.
Yeah, he is, playing Bagheera.
Yeah, which I thought it was brilliant as Bagheera.
How good is John Goodman as Baloo.
As Baloo?
Yeah.
In which version? The
Oh, wait a minute. I'm thinking about Jungle Book 2.
Oh, Jungle Book 2. Yeah,
the second one, made in 2003.
I'm sorry, but
who did the one for the new film?
I believe it was Bill Murray.
Yes. Bill Murray, of course.
Bill Murray was awesome.
How could I have forgotten that?
You can't beat him, okay?
Man, that was amazing.
Ghostbusters, Caddyshack, Bill Murray's an all-around awesome
guy. He's one of my
favourite.
Stripes.
His Stripes was good. Stripes was brilliant.
But yeah, he's had quite a resurgence since his Sofia Coppola movie, Lost in Translation.
Yes.
And since then, he's made films for Jim Jarmusch in Broken Flowers. Mm-hmm. He's such a great actor. And he's recently been in so many movies, yeah. Like St. Vincent as well. Saw that one?
I saw St. Vincent.
I loved him in
that. That's
hey,
nice.
Ruth,
hi.
How are you?
Hi, welcome again.
Thank you.
Time for something to eat.
You know what you want?
I will go with the Huey burger, please.
Yeah. And to drink?
Coke. Thanks.
You know, I heard some really good stuff about the Palmer. So
yeah, it's my favourite.
Yeah? It's your favourite? I'm going to go for the Palmer. I'm hungry like an
and
elephant.
You're feeling it? Yeah.
Coke, please. Yeah.
And do you feel like a small fries?
Yeah, oh, yeah. Something to share. Yeah.
I think we're good. Yeah. I think we're good.
That sauce you guys have is amazing.
Oh. Definitely.
Is perfect. It homemade?
Yeah. The Kick-Ass and the Ring of Fire are.
Yeah, yeah.
The Tai-Fis from New Zealand. It's
those
not
are my favourite.
Oh, okay.
Brilliant.
All right.
Yeah.
Wait,
thanks
for
that. Right. Thanks, Ruth.
Thank you.
Yeah,
Bill Murray, yeah, he voiced Baloo in a unique way because John Goodman in Jungle Book 2, which was a terrible movie, he really tried to emulate Baloo's character in the first 1967 movie.
Yes.
Who voiced that one? That was...
It was Phil Harris.
Phil Harris.
Yeah.
He was a comedian from the 1960s.
Yeah, and his voice is recognisable because in the Aristocats as a tomboy cat, you can't beat him. And Aristocats is another one of my favourite Disney films.
But you know, both the new film and the old one, 1967 versions, they're both loosely based on Rudyard Kipling's collection of Jungle Book stories.
Yes.
And they're all short stories. I think there were seven stories
in
the original book.
Total, yes.
And only three of those short stories were used as the basis
for
Disney, Jungle Book.
Well, Disney took aspects from the seven books in order to make this, which is interesting because it goes through every single process, but maybe has like 10 minutes or so to show it. But there was a lot of stuff that, this is why I was so annoyed about the 2016 version. There was stuff there that they could have included more with.
Yeah.
In particular, Car. Car was not a bad person. Car was supposed to be a hero and saving Mowgli from the monkeys in using not hypnotic eyes, but using a hypnotic dance, sort of like showing the Indian style that it was.
Wow.
But Scarlett Johansson as Car, I wanted to see more. And maybe that was because she was off doing Avengers.
Oh, look, she's just going to read the lines that she's given.
That's true.
You know what I mean? They probably should have developed the character itself in general. Whatever script they would have written, she would have read it.
Well, yeah, that's,
you know
that's
what I mean?
Actually true. But,
but
I want
she
to
did
a,
something, and I think the reason why Jon Favreau used Scarlett Johansson in it was
because
he
directed Iron Man 1 and 2.
Well, yes, he's worked with her in the past, but he's also wanted to include more female characters in Jungle Book, because if you remember in the 1967 version,
it was a male.
The
girl who was singing at the end.
Only the girl who was singing at the end, but also the mother of the wolves.
Yes.
Those are the only two female characters in a largely male-dominated story.
Mm. And I mean, Raksha.
Raksha.
The mother of
Lupita
the wolf pack.
Nyong'o.
Yeah. Which was in 12 Years
like
a Slave.
It's a Lupita Nyong'o.
Yeah.
Nyong'o. Can't say it right. She's from Kenya.
Yeah. But she was great because I loved her in 12 Years of Slave.
There's something about her voice which is very
calming,
knowledgeable and possesses wisdom, you know? And I thought she was more effective as Raksha than the mother in the original.
I believe so too. And
But also, Jon Favreau built that scene where the wolves discuss and argue between themselves whether they should keep Mowgli or let him into the wild.
Because in the 1967, what? It lasted like 5 minutes.
30 seconds.
Yeah, and it wasn't even
They were on the
there.
Rock. They were discussing yep. his future, his fate.
Exactly.
And it wasn't really developed very well.
No.
Whereas in the new one, and that's another thing I really like.
They show it.
There's a whole build-up to why they let him go. And you really feel an emotional core to his place in the jungle.
Yeah.
Because you feel as though he's been abandoned. I mean, he was found as a baby. And in this film, it was different. He was found in a cave.
Yep.
His father had been killed by Shere Khan.
But that was part of the book.
Yeah.
Which is what was different to the Disney one.
Yeah.
But come on. Disney cannot show death all that
I like that more, though. Because in the 1967 version, he was found in a canoe, in a broken canoe.
Yeah, yeah.
There's no real... Well, you know what? It's actually... I'm torn. The 1967 Disney one, he's found in the canoe. Mm. Because the Mowgli's a baby, there's no way he would ever know where he comes from.
Mm.
Right?
That's true.
He would have no idea what caused the canoe to break or what happened.
So it would show that he adapts to the jungle, kind of like Tarzan would. Yeah.
In the new movie, however, nobody who raises Mowgli knows how... He was abandoned or found, or what caused him to be lost in the jungle. It was only Shao Kahn, and Shao Kahn was the one who went into the cave.
He was targeting him, but his father got in the way.
Yeah.
So, he just left him, and that's when Bagheera showed up. And where were the elephants? Where was the colonel to show that sense of security and to show that they were the rulers of the jungle, the ones that command? Because the bit in the 1967 version was a classic. Mm. When you have the colonel marching with all of them, shows
that was
an actual army.
I love that.
It's hilarious.
Yeah.
Especially, they did show the little baby elephant, but no voice. There was nothing there. He didn't have his trademark stick. And the biggest problem I had, no car. Shere Khan was aggressive. He was vicious.
Also in the new movie, elephants don't talk. You just see them passing and everyone bows in their presence because they're like the kings of the jungle.
And that's not what I wanted. That is not what I wanted. Yeah. At least get
someone. So you were disappointed by that aspect?
I was very disappointed by it. Okay. And the fact is also the fact that as I was going through the motions, going back to relating to the novel, he doesn't go back to the village.
Yeah.
Which is not what happened in the book. He actually goes back to the village, which is what Disney got right. But then, when he turns 17, he goes back to the jungle.
You do know that the 1967 version was Walt Disney's last film before he died.
Yes.
He actually died during the making of the movie. And he took a lot of liberties in changing the story because Bill Peet, he wrote the original adaptation of the screen.
Yes.
He's made so many of the most famous Disney films like Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs, Sleeping Beauty, Dumbo, Peter Pan,
and
all the biggest and best ones, right? And Bill Peet was approached to do the storyboard for this one, and he wanted the boy to constantly move between civilization, the
humans, man village,
the man village, and the jungle, back and forth, back and forth, and Walt Disney disagreed with him. They had this huge row. Walt Disney insisted that the story ends with him coming to the man village.
But that's kind of a sad ending in a way.
I think it's a better ending.
Oh, it's definitely a better ending. I mean, I didn't particularly like the ending of the 2016 version because of that. I think my mouth dropped when I saw the end of it. I'm like, that can't be it. No. Yeah. He's supposed to go back to the man village and then he comes back 17 years later, which is a follow-up that they did, Rudyard Kipling actually did. When he's 17, he comes back to the jungle.
Yeah.
So. Here
you
guys.
There's your parma burger.
That is so unique.
Whoa.
Thank you.
I was expecting
schnitzel
with,
It's under there.
That is
and then
awesome.
Cut them in half and use your fingers.
Okay.
That is brilliant.
Cool.
Serviettes and whatever you need over there, but I'll give you a chips.
Thank you so much, Ruth. Yum. Dig in, man. Dig in.
Yeah. I've actually been waiting to come back here and have another one of these famous burgers. And I've already torn it apart. I'm terrible.
Oh my God.
Put this back on.
this is amazing.
Mm.
And the tomato sauce should have been over there. And this is aioli, garlic mayonnaise.
Thank you.
Ruth, this is
absolutely
brilliant.
Perfect.
Thank you so much.
It tastes delicious.
Mm.
Enjoy.
Thank you.
So, Walt Disney, he had a disagreement with Bill Peet, and he hired Larry Clemens to finish the story.
Yeah, to finish it.
And, it was a better ending. I thought by having most of the story take place in the jungle and then ending it at the man village, it's almost like a passage into manhood and an end of beginning of a new chapter in his life, but leaving his friends behind. And there's that emotional core that's left behind as well.
Yeah, you can't just play Bare Necessities and end the song, okay? You can't just do that to try and... Oh, okay, it's all right. Seriously, he'll be all right. But at the same time, that girl, he was whipped as soon as he saw her.
Oh, yeah.
And, you know, I remember when I was watching it when I was a kid, and I looked at this, and I'm like, oh, okay, he just likes her. No, I could see. He was like, head over heels. Yes.
She drops that water jug on purpose.
Exactly.
And he goes after it.
Yep. And that's just, you know, I think Baloo actually
How one-dimensional was Jungle Book 2?
Can we not talk about it? I hated it.
No, but like, it was a literal rehash of the first one. It was just capitalizing on the success of the first one by just repeating the story. Shere Khan is out there again. Shere Khan wants the man cub. Although in that one, in the new one, he doesn't have the scar in his eye, which doesn't make any sense whatsoever. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. The animation is so poor and so lazy, has no detail, no depth of field, no... You know how in the original there was a matte?
Yeah, because it was hand-drawn. Yeah.
It was hand-drawn, but they were matte'd, so there was depth. Mm-hmm. So
to give the
you had the impression that the camera was moving and the trees were like overlapping each other and moving as a consequence.
Yeah.
I loved that sense of three-dimensional space.
Yeah, even then.
Even then.
To achieve it.
Exactly. Yeah.
Some of the other things I had a problem with. I liked the original Shao Kahn. Because
Sanders had just the most amazing voice.
Exactly. And he was calm, collected, sophisticated, but at the same time, he was meant to be feared.
But also, the animation was so far superior to the subsequent animated film that came in 2003. I just can't believe Disney developed it. It cost $20 million to make the second one, right?
It was terrible.
The first one cost $4 million to make. I understand it's a different era and adjusted for inflation and all that.
It generated more.
But generated way more. But the animation in the 2003 version, with all the technology that we had at that time, with all the resources that Disney, the world's most powerful production company,
couldn't pull off.
It was just, it had a slower frame rate, so they used less cells.
Yep. They didn't do that matte effect.
They didn't use the matte effect. The colors had no depth, so they were just like either orange or red. It was lazy. It wasn't really. They didn't spend a lot of time making it.
Even Baloo's color and Bagheera's, all the colors actually of all of them, they looked too pale, washed out.
Yeah, there was a lot more emphasis as well on singing.
Yeah,
there was no story. I mean, it was a rehash.
Mm.
A rehash.
Did you like Christopher Walken as King Louis?
Yes, I love that. And they got his facial expressions perfectly. And do you know, Jon Favreau based that depiction of King Louis on Colonel Kurtz from Apocalypse Now?
I thought they did.
You know how Marlon Brando, he's in the middle of the jungle in Apocalypse Now? He doesn't belong there. He's a white American man stuck in the Vietnamese-Cambodian jungle.
Mm.
And that's what that's what Jon Favreau wanted to do, because, you know, orangutans, they're not native to India.
No.
How did he get there? That's a mystery. Not only is he an orangutan, he's one of those prehistoric orangutans.
One of the ones with the big ears.
Oh, yeah. But he was like 10 times bigger than all the other monkeys.
Yeah. But I mean, even then, because in the 1967 one, he was same size.
Yeah.
Just maybe a little bit bigger than Mowgli, but, you know. And that wasn't really, like, as threatening. Christopher Walken, I thought, was a better portrayal. but I was just waiting for him to say, this watch, I carried it for 16 years, something. Pick a sad I'll song and make
gotta,
it better.
You gotta make, give it some respect.
Hey, dude. I was waiting for that, and you know,
but like
it
they
comes
got the
across.
They got the facial expression so perfect.
They got it spot on. I will agree with that.
Yeah.
But it comes across the Christopher Walken voice for when he's singing, mainly.
Absolutely.
But when he was talking, it took me a while.
Yeah.
Because I couldn't see it, and maybe that's because you know he's trying to die down with that whole Christopher Walken character that everyone knows and loves. I loved Idris Elba as Shere Khan. Okay. But at the same time, I think that they told him, we want to have a evil sort of Bengal tiger. Mm-hmm. As soon as he entered, and the other thing, they showed him straight away.
Yeah.
They should have left him as like, you know, even had him in the shadows about this whole thing about what happened with Mowgli.
Yeah.
How his father got killed. Mm-hmm. Have it as like a thing, because the way that they showed it in 1967 was just eyes. And you just see the grass parting and you see how evil he is. And just that he's a laid back, he reminded me a lot of Scar. But at the same time, he still had that perfect portrayal.
Yeah, yeah.
But that was one of the other things I hated. The fact is, King Louis, he was good. He was good as Christopher Walken was good as King Louis. And Mowgli. Mowgli, I will agree, was better than the original because he was smarter. But at the same time, he was too smart.
Yeah.
Because he was making everything. He knew how to make the buckets to catch water. He knew how to make
what
that.
What did you think of Neil Sethi as Mowgli? It's only his second film.
Only
he
was his
in
second,
some kind of
was,
short.
He was in a short film.
Yeah. It was called Diwali.
Yeah, Diwali.
In 2013. Yeah.
And that was good.
Yeah.
I liked it.
Yeah,
and
so did I.
He brought emotion, depth, character. And I thought, this is a really good actor that I can see going a long way.
Yeah. The music in the original was just spellbinding. From the moment that book opens and it zooms in and it begins, and you hear that exotic, you know, classical.
You feel like you're being transported into that world,
man.
And that's what made it different.
Yeah, it's an untouched, beautiful, almost dreamlike place, the Indian jungle.
It was a work of art.
And I think one of what Jon Favreau said in an interview recently is that, you know, when Rudyard Kipling wrote the book, the novel in 1894, India was still relatively untouched compared to today.
Mm.
It was, you know, under the colonial British Empire, but the environment was not endangered yet. It was still there and it was still fast and much of it was unexplored by white man.
It was.
Today, we're protecting the environment. Back then, we were not protecting it. We were living it. So Favreau paid a particular emphasis in the new movie on the environment.
Yeah.
And you'll notice, and obviously with the new and extended duration of the new film, you have a sense of his surroundings. There are so many sounds, noises, and the ambience of the jungle is so deep.
But where was it shot? Because I was looking everywhere for it, and I couldn't figure out where it was.
What?
Where the 2016 version was shot.
Yes, a lot of it was shot, a lot of photography was done in actual Indian locations, but much of it obviously was done in a green screen, right?
Much of it
And coming back to what I was saying about Favreau putting a lot of emphasis into the environmental conservation, remember how much the film was pressing the idea of Mowgli running around with the red flower? Now, in the 1967 cartoon, there was no...
They didn't
no,
call it Red Flower.
They didn't even talk about fire like it was something so vicious and scary.
Well, King Louis did talk about it, and that's the only time we heard about it.
Yes.
Yeah.
But in this new one, fire is like the most terrifying thing, and it completely engulfs and destroys everything that it touches. And do you remember Mowgli at the end? He sets the whole forest on fire, and the animals are suddenly questioning their relationship to him.
And that's why I was kind of like a bit shocked, because how are they going to be able to come back from this? They've just noticed him doing it. And but even then, there wasn't really a sense of like, oh, I'm sorry, or anything.
And that's
like
another quite scary thing, is that Shao Kahn falls and dies in the fire.
But he dies in the book, so that's why.
Yes, but in the 67 version, which was
he runs off.
Which was more catered to the children.
Yeah.
He runs off with the with fire the attached to his tail. Yeah. So there are quite a lot of differences. It's not like a complete remake.
No. But it definitely did its job.
Yeah.
I will agree.
I think both of them are great in their own right, but obviously neither of them can emulate the depth and the quality of the book.
Look for the bare necessities, the simple bare necessities. Forget about your worries and your strife. I mean the bare necessities, or Mother Nature's recipes that bring the bare necessities of life. Wherever I wander, wherever I roam, I couldn't be found off my big home. The bees are buzzing in the tree to make some honey just for me. When you look under the rocks and plants and take a glance at the fancy ants, then maybe try a few. The bare necessities of life will come to you. They'll come to you. Look for the bare necessities, the simple bare necessities. Forget about your worries and your strife. I mean the bare necessities, that's why a bear...